Tell me you feeling alright. Tryna get with you tonight. I'm with all the shit that you like. I'm with all the shit that you like.
Tell me where you wanna go. Tell me what you wanna do. Baby, just be comfortable.
What's good, everybody? Today we're gonna do a story time video. Welcome back to our channel, Jamie and Ivan. And let's get it.
Today, our story time is going to be how we first met.
Yeah, it wasn't the prettiest, it wasn't the coolest, it wasn't romantic, really much, but it is what it is. So, how you want to start it off?
Okay, so basically, we met through a friend, one of my friends, and she knew his, well, both of them, him and his brother, because they, like, grew up in the same building or whatever.
Yeah.
So, me and her, we was walking in Coney Island, and he was walking with one of his friends. So she said hi to him, and
it was like, I haven't seen her in a minute. So, you know, she was like a little childhood friend. So she was a childhood friend. So basically, like, when I saw her, I was like, oh shit, what's up? But I think I didn't see her. Did she peep me first?
I don't know.
Well, yeah, we saw each other. We was like, yo, what up, shit like that. I knew her from, like, social media, but I never talked to her, like, at all. I just knew her that, because I had her as a friend on Facebook, right?
No.
Yes.
No, you added me that day.
Oh. Well, yeah, I added her that day, but I knew her from social media.
He knew me from, like, previous parties. Basically,
yeah, I really before me, I got with her, me, I used to party and everything, and she used to party too, but I never spoke to her, whatever.
We just seen each other, we never spoke, so whatever. Like I was saying, we was walking, whatever. So she said hi to him, and I knew his friend from a party, I guess. So he said hi to me. And then, I don't know, something, I think you said to her, oh, put me onto your friend or something like that. And from there, I said hi to him or whatever. And he added me on Facebook, whatever. Then from there, we was texting, like, every now and then.
Yeah, when we saw each other on the app, I'm like, yo, inbox me. Well, I'm going to inbox you. That's how I'm going to inbox you. And she was like mad dry with it. She was like, all right, whatever. Kept it pushing. I went home. Well, I went somewhere with my mans. She went about her business. And I added you that night. I added her at nighttime. And I hit her up. And to the rest.
I know, we was just talking from there. He didn't really take it serious. And I guess I didn't either at first. I mean, I did, but it was like, once I saw that he wasn't serious, I was just like, all right, whatever, why am I even trying?
I thought it was gonna be reverse, but it ended up being her taking it serious first. Because I'm like, because back then I never used to do, like, you know, relationships or whatnot. So I'm like, all right, I'm gonna just talk to her and see where, like, it leads to. And we was talking and shit, and she would text me. I won't text her. Like, I would text her like 6 hours later, and she would like try to talk to me. And then it was this one night, I remember we FaceTimed, and she was all sad looking. I'm like, the fuck? Like, we was on FaceTime. I think we FaceTimed for the night.
That day you was in PA.
Was?
I think so.
That was in my father house, yeah, in PA. And we was on FaceTime, and I you know, I'm chilling with my friends, my brothers, and I went to a separate room. I'm like, I'm speaking to her, and she looking all sad. So I'm like, so what's up, what's going on? And I guess you told me how you felt about me.
I asked her
like, how you feel about me? And she told me, and then I was like, oh, okay. And I was, you know, trying to play along with it.
He didn't care, basically.
And then one day hit me, like, yo, I need to stop, drop everything I got, right? And talk to her because she was showing me mad, like, attention. So I'm like, all right, let me see you. And then I gave her a shot, her attention. I'm like, yo, I see something in you type shit, blah, blah, blah.
But I didn't believe it.
But I was serious. I'm like, yo,
I think I still have the message. I don't know. But he said something. And he actually sent me a picture. It was a meme of something that said, I forgot what it said.
What if he really cares?
Yeah, it was something. It was like,
what if he
really? It was like, what if he, what if you think he's playing you, but he's really not? It was something like that. And I was just like, LOL. Like, I really didn't believe it.
But I was serious because, not to get me wrong, before that, I shot her that text, I was doing me. So I'm like, chilling. But then something hit me. I woke up one morning like, yo, I need to stop. Boom, boom, boom. Let me talk to her. Shit like that. Let's get it. And then I guess she didn't believe it because
I didn't believe it. So that's why I was just like, whatever. I'm not even gonna pay it any mind. But we were still like texting here and there until I finally realized like he's really serious. Like we would be with each other every other day, but like, you know, like, okay, so in Coney Island, basically, like every Friday there's fireworks, so like I would come over and we'd just hang out, and then I'd leave and go to like my friend on the boardwalk, and he would just, his mom would always tell him, oh, why don't you take her to go see the fireworks.
I was shocked
because, and I would be like, yeah, okay, and I just walk away, like, because I knew he wasn't gonna do it. And then not only that, he went to go see somebody else after anyway, so I was just like,
what you mean somebody else? I used to go link my bros, and we used to go to the fireworks, and then I would end up seeing her at the fireworks with her friend, and I'll
and be, he wouldn't even say nothing.
I was just,
he would like act like I was never there.
But her friend will play, and she
would. But she would always go up to him, like she would make it obvious that he was there.
Like she wanted me to say something, or she, because I'm trying to avoid her.
Yeah, he didn't want to say nothing to me.
And
like we wasn't just together 10 minutes before that.
So I used to think of it like, yo, what the hell? I don't need to say hi again. But her friend would come up to me, and she's mad short. She would tap me in the back. I would look back, and I'll end up looking down like,
yo, you're annoying.
I end up looking down like, oh, this girl.
And then, oh, it'll be this
her friend.
Girl.
It'll be her friend. And like inside my head, I would be like, I know she's doing this purposely so she could get Jamie to say hi to me, or I could get, so she wants me to say hi to Jamie, whatever. And then I try to avoid her, but every Friday it came down to me saying hi to her or whatever. And then
every Friday was the same, by the way.
Yeah, lead to the next point.
Okay, so basically, like,
where I really got serious.
So after that, like after all that summer crap, that's when school came back along. And during school, he had football season and everything, so
I
he
remember,
was barely talking at the time because he was always at practice. So yeah.
I remember one time when school started, I'm like, I hit her with her status. I tagged her. I'm like, I know who's gonna be doing my homework this school year, and I tagged her.
Because he's horrible in math, and math is my favorite subject, so he would always ask me to do his homework.
So she used to be doing my homework, so I'm like,
only math though, nothing yeah. else.
So I would be like, oh shit, like that was a little, I guess, step up. For me to really,
like, oh, she's actually doing something for me.
And I'll always underestimate you, right? I'll be like, yo, bring me food, boom, boom, boom. You're like, I got you. I'm like, yeah, okay.
And I would not bring him food. Nah, sometimes I would, but I wouldn't. Sometimes I wouldn't.
And then when she gets it, she'd be like, I don't know why you're always underestimating me, boom, boom, boom. Because when I say something, I'm going to do it. I'm like, all right, but.
And then he always used to feed for oxtails.
That's my favorite.
I don't know why. Those are...
Oxtails is good. But, yeah.
From Flatbush?
Huh?
From Flatbush?
Fuck Flatbush. Like, what the fuck?
All right, stop. We're not going to bring this.
Anyways, yeah. So, I'm like, yeah. Bring me some oxtails, whatever. And then... It would end up being me bringing her stuff or me getting her stuff. So
I was spoiled, but I still am.
Then it was like,
so don't get it twisted.
Then it was like, yo, I'm legit gonna like officially get with her. Like, so we got with each other.
May 5th, 2015.
Yeah, May 5th, 2015.
And
May 4th.
Oh shit.
Well, like slapping her.
Oh, I was thinking of the first number, cause you know I don't usually say May, I just say 5, 4, 15.
But yeah. So yeah, I dropped, yo, after this video she's getting beat up.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, I dropped everything cause I used to talk to girls. So I dropped all of that, put that away. And
away.
I put it. What the fuck you want me to
do? You put it away, so save it for later.
I put it to the garbage. I threw it in all the way in Pacific Ocean. Get the fuck out. Oh. And left them drowning, whatnot. But yeah, so we got together, and then every month of our anniversary, we will post a video. Every month,
post a video.
She will make a video, and we both will post it.
I will post it. You would share it.
Whatever. And then we used to get mad clout off of that, like mad attention. Like everybody used to share it, heart
and then
it,
we
comment.
Like, we got off of Facebook for like a while.
Yeah.
So now that we came back on Facebook, it's like nobody shows us love.
But you feel me? We're gonna get back.
But it's okay there. Because all the haters gonna hate. It's okay.
But we good, we good. Trust me, we good. And our year. You know how other relationships, or they say the beginning is always the best. This relationship, the beginning wasn't
the worst. The beginning is the worst.
But now, look at us.
Now, if you guys need relationship, like any of relationship advice, text me because I'm the best at it.
Yeah, she's like a lawyer.
No, I'm like Dr. Phil, like a love doctor.
My nigga was cheating on me. My nigga, and then she would write them paragraphs, and then I will be here sitting down, like yo. Hi, time is over. And then she would be just texting them. Like, so I'll just
I'm
play
like
my 2K
doctor.
Or whatever.
I'm the love doctor.
But yeah, she always look out for people and shit like that. So she don't be fake. But she is annoying. But yeah,
but
that was
me.
A...
Huh? But you love me.
Yeah, you are. But that was our story time, right? You got any more to tell them?
Okay, so like I was saying with this school-wise thing, like when school came along and he was like always in football, I used to hate it. Like I always wanted to tell him, to tell his coach to like...
Shh, what if he watches this?
Like I used to hate it. Like his coach used to get me so mad.
He used to keep us hostage. Like legit, we would be on the field. We would start.
I used to tell him to tell his coach I'm calling the cops on.
We start on the field at 2 o'clock, and we would end practice around like 6:30.
No, not even. It used to end at like 7.
Sometimes on his worst day, it would be on 7.
I was so
mad. His good day was 6:30.
So yeah, whatever. And then that's when it came to football season.
And then yeah, she would be my little number one fan, and she would pop out to my games, and I was to wake up with paragraphs. Remember that? I the night before I would be like, "Yo, you already know what to do in the morning." I guess she would set an alarm because
no alarm. I always used to wake up before you, and I had to wake you up too.
She used to wake me up with long, cute ass paragraphs, motivational, like, yo, you better go out there and fuck these niggas. Alright, yeah, babe. And I would have good ass games and shit like that.
And I was always there. Like, yeah. Little do you guys know, I have like every football gear for myself. Like, I swear.
She has sweaters, she has shirts, she has all that.
I have shorts.
Shorts, all that. She's my number one fan, and she always makes sure she pops out to my game, and I make sure she pops out to my game, wearing my jersey and doing that, whatever.
Even if they're away, but if they're like in like West Bubble, I'm not going over there. I'm
yeah, like it would be crazy because sometimes after the game, say if I have a home game, right? No, I have a away game, and the next game is home. I will, after our game, we go in the locker room, take off my jersey. I would just leave it. Like, I would take off my clothes, throw in the locker room, leave. I'd be like, all right, next day I'm going to go get my jersey, right? Next day comes, I don't get the jersey. I feel like I'm too lazy, whatever. We practicing the whole week for our home game. Then I'm like, oh, shit. Wifey got to wear my away jersey. So I have to bring the jersey home, clean it, wash it, whatever, so she could wear it.
Yo, he used to bring me my jersey every time.
Your jersey.
Oh, what number is on your jersey? My jersey, you mean.
And you know what's crazy? Our date is 5/4/15, and my number is 5/4.
And then his basketball number used to be 15.
Yeah. So that shit was all crazy. So yeah, she used to come to my games, whatever, take videos of me, taking pictures, being a little creep.
Right? Maybe if I still have some, I'll put it at the end.
Yeah, maybe. But yeah, if you got anything else to say?
No, not really.
That was our story time, how we met. It wasn't the best, but guess what? Me and her are strong now. We still working
with each other. We still had our ups and downs, not even gonna lie.
Yeah, we still had our ups and downs.
Relationships aren't perfect.
Nope.
So
if you're if your relationship is perfect, it's fake. Something wrong.
No, if your wrong. Relationship is perfect, it's fake.
There's no somebody's relationship. Cheating. Yeah, yeah. Something is wrong, like, you better be checking the messages. But not always, it's not all the time, but whatever. But so, yeah, that was our story time. For the people who requested the story time, from basically people who don't know us, like from out of state, or whatever, there goes your knowing of our relationship, how we met, and everything. Hope you guys liked it. Give it a thumbs up, share, like, comment, subscribe, and make sure you give us ideas. Continue, because you're actually doing good. I'm receiving a lot of ideas. I don't know if she is, but I'm receiving.
I got some pranks today, so
I'm gonna say nothing, but I got some good ass ideas. Continue it, please.
I'm still waiting for you to prank please. Me back, but it looks like
I'm gonna let her sleep. I'm gonna continue letting her sleep on me, and let's get it. Make sure you send me the pranks, right. The ideas.
Anyways, follow us on all our social medias. And yeah, that's it. Bye, guys.
Mexicano, working like a Mexicano. New persona, I'm moving off of Ferragamo. Get the llama, I party with the real Madonna. Beat the odds, do numbers, and remain humble. Death tie punches, I'm so used to this. Bugging at the play, I'm not so used to this. I know where I'm from, but I got used to this. Mansion in the hills, I got used to this. Shake a booty bitches, I got used to this. This ice flood in my wrist, I done got used to this.